This is Captain Philip with Airworthy Tours, your guide in the sky. And today we're taking a tour of Chicago, which is actually my birth city. In today's tour, we're gonna take a look at Chicago's skyline, its architecture, and its many attractions and landmarks. With that being said, sit back, relax, and enjoy the tour. Chicago was founded in 1833, and it quickly became an important transportation and railroad hub between the East and the West Coast. For several decades, it was the world's fastest growing city, and today Chicago is the third most populous city in the U.S. behind New York City and Los Angeles, with a population of 2.7 million according to the 2020 census. The city sits right off of Lake Michigan. Lake Michigan is one of the five Great Lakes. At 22,404 square miles, it is the third largest Great Lake, and it is the largest lake by area in only one country. Surrounded by the four U.S. states of Michigan, Illinois, Wisconsin, and Indiana, some 12 million people live along the shores of the lake. Chicago is known for its great architectural tradition, and there's a good reason for that. In October of 1871, the Great Chicago Fire destroyed an area about 4 miles or 6.4 kilometers long and 1 mile or 1.6 kilometers wide, a large section of the city at the time, causing 300 deaths, leaving 100,000 homeless, and $222 million in damages, which equates to $4.7 billion in today's rate. Despite the wide-scale destruction, much of the city, including railroads and stockyards, survived intact, and Chicago was given many generous donations after the fire to rebuild. Rebuilding after the Chicago Fire of 1871 was swift and legendary. Rubble and ash were pushed into the lake to make new neighborhoods. By 1900, Chicago was the fifth largest city in the world. And from the ruins of the previous wooden structures arose more modern constructions of steel and stone, setting the precedent for worldwide construction. In fact, tall building construction was invented in Chicago. With the construction of the 130-foot-high Home Insurance Building, constructed in 1884, it was the world's first skyscraper, making Chicago the birthplace of the skyscraper. It has the second largest skyline in the United States behind New York City. In total, Chicago has over 1,200 high-rise buildings and 117 breathtaking skyscrapers. It currently has 5 of the country's 15 tallest buildings, with more skyscrapers on the way, most notably the Salesforce Chicago Tower, which is set to open in 2023. Ahead is the Willis Tower. Formerly the Sears Tower, it stands at 1,450 feet or 442 meters tall and has 110 stories. The original vision and reason for the Willis Tower came to life in 1969. When Sears, Roebuck & Company decided it needed a central office space for its 350,000 employees. After breaking ground in 1970, construction took 3 years to complete, at a cost of $175 million to build, and the project employed over 2,000 construction workers. Upon its completion in 1973, it surpassed the World Trade Center in New York City to become the tallest building in the world, a title that it held for nearly 25 years, being replaced by the Petronas Towers in Kuala Lumpur in 1998. The Willis Tower remained the tallest building in the Western Hemisphere for 41 years, until the One World Trade Center surpassed it in 2014. At the time of this tour, the Willis Tower is now the 25th tallest building in the world, and the third tallest in the United States. In 1988, Sears, Roebuck & Company sold and moved out of the building, but the name Sears Tower remained until 2009, when the building was renamed after the Willis Group, a London-based global insurance broker. However, many locals still refer to it as the Sears Tower. Another great area to view Chicago's architecture is the Chicago River. Ahead is the Merchandise Mart, which is a large commercial building holding up to 4 million square feet of floor space. When it first opened in 1930, it was the largest building by volume in the world, and the building had its own zip code until 2008.
The merchandise mart was designed by Chicago's legendary architectural firm, Graham Anderson Probst & White. This firm was responsible for some of Chicago's iconic buildings, such as the Wrigley Building, the Field Museum, and the Shedd Aquarium. Another interesting building on the riverfront is the Marina City. Affectionately known as the Corn Cob, the Marina City is a mixed-use residential commercial building complex where you can park your car and boat under the same roof. Despite its amenities and strategic location in downtown Chicago, you can rent a studio apartment here for $1,500 a month. To learn more about Chicago's architecture, I highly recommend taking one of the many architectural river tours. In total, the Chicago River is 156 miles or 251 kilometers long, and some 45 bridges span the river in downtown Chicago. But did you know that the Chicago River has a man-made reverse flow? In 1885, a severe storm caused the river to empty large amounts of sewage-polluted water into Lake Michigan, which threatened Chicago's water supply, and thus plans were begun to reverse its flow. This was accomplished through the construction of a canal, which was completed in 1900. The river now flows inland and into the Illinois Waterway, which connects it to the Mississippi River, giving Chicago direct access to the Gulf of Mexico. The reversal of the river's flow is considered one of the greatest feats of modern engineering. Now, you can't have the second tallest skyline in the country and not have a robust economy. The total economic output of Chicago and gross metropolitan product totaled $737 billion in 2019, making Chicago equivalent to the 20th largest economy in the world. To give you a good perspective, that is a larger economy than the country of Switzerland. The Chicago metropolitan area has 34 corporate headquarters, which is second in the nation. Known companies headquartered in the Chicago metro area include Boeing, McDonald's, Walgreens, United Airlines, TransUnion, Allstate, Grubhub, Groupon, and Orbitz. Next is the McCormick Place. With 2.6 million square feet of exhibit floor space, it is the largest convention center in the United States. Opened in 1960, the McCormick Place has expanded four times in 1986, 1997, 2007, and 2017. Today, the McCormick Place is made up of four buildings and one indoor arena that holds 10,000 people. Some 3 million people attend the McCormick Place for its many trade shows and conventions a year. Next is the Magnificent Mile, a 13-block upscale and historic stretch of North Michigan Avenue. The Magnificent Mile has more than 460 stores, 275 restaurants, 60 hotels, and some very historic buildings and landmarks, including the Wrigley Building, the Tribune Tower, the Chicago Water Tower, and the Drake Hotel. The Magnificent Mile is like a cross between New York's Times Square and LA's Rodeo Drive. Rent off this strip is the eighth most expensive in the world. Speaking of shopping, make sure to check out our gift shop at www.airworthyprints.com, where you can get a stunning poster of Chicago and elsewhere for your home, office, or home office. Also, if you would like to license some of the footage in this video and on our channel, make sure to contact us via email, which I will leave in the description box.
Quick food break, because Chicago is my favorite food city in the US. And that is because it is a carnivore's paradise. Now, we've all come across a Chicago hot dog in our lifetime, but the one thing I have to get while in Chicago is an Italian beef sandwich, which is kind of like a Philly cheesesteak, but with Italian beef and peppers. You can get a good one at a restaurant called Portillo's. However, we all know that Chicago's most known food item is a deep dish pizza. Now, there are two really popular deep dish pizza spots in Chicago, Lou Malnati's and Giordano's. And I had a chance to eat at both of these restaurants in two successive days, where I picked a winner, which is Giordano's. While Lou Malnati's has a great tasting crust, which I do love, I just like the overall taste of the Giordano's pizza, from the cheese, the sauce, the meat, and the crust. So I know this is gonna cause a lot of controversy, but let me know your favorite deep dish spot in Chicago in the comment section below. Now let's continue with the rest of our tour, because I have a lot of attractions I want to show you all.
Chicago has a large tourism industry. Despite its cold weather, the city sees over 50 million visitors a year. And we'll be looking at some of Chi-Town's most famous attractions. Our first stop is Navy Pier. At 3,300 feet or 1,000 meters, Navy Pier is one of Chicago's most popular tourist destinations and contains up to 50 acres of gardens, theme park attractions, shops, restaurants, concert venues, and parks. Navy Pier originally opened in 1916 as an amusement area and shipping facility. In 1927, the pier was renamed Navy Pier to honor the naval veterans who served in World War I. Between 1942 to 1945, pilot and Navy training took place at the pier, and an estimated 200 World War II planes still rest at the bottom of the lake as a result of accidents during training. After a period of decline and disuse, Navy Pier was redesigned and redeveloped in 1991. In 1995, the revamped Navy Pier was introduced to the public as a mixed-use venue, incorporating retail, dining, entertainment, and cultural spaces. Since its reopening, an estimated 180 million guests have come to enjoy the pier and its many entertainment options. Our next stop is Cloud Gate, also known as The Bean. It is one of Chicago's most popular attractions. Cloud Gate was built in 2006 by renowned sculptor Anish Kapoor. Cloud Gate measures 66 feet long and 33 feet high and weighs 100 tons. Construction cost $23 million, and no public funds were involved. All funding came from donations from individuals and corporations. Cloud Gate sits upon AT&T Plaza, which was made possible by a gift from AT&T. Its reflective surface was inspired by liquid mercury. This shiny exterior reflects the people moving around the park and the surrounding skyline and green space. In addition, the polished surface invites visitors to touch the sculpture and observe their own reflection, giving it a unique interactive experience. In 2017, Cloud Gate was crowned by the Chicago Tribune as the top tourist destination in Chicago, seeing an estimated 25 million visitors a year. Our next stop is Buckingham Fountain. The fountain was opened on May 26, 1927, and was donated by Kate S. Buckingham in honor of her brother Clarence. The Buckingham Fountain is considered one of the first ornamental fountains in America. The fountain's water capacity is 1.5 million gallons, with major displays recirculating approximately 14,000 gallons of water per minute, conveyed through its 134 jets. On days that is operational, the fountain produces a major water display for 20 minutes every hour. During the major display, a center jet shoots water to a height of 150 feet into the air. Major displays begin daily at 9 a.m. and continue thereafter, every hour, on the hour. Next is the illustrious Field Museum of Natural History. The Field Museum and its collections date back to the 1893 World's Columbian Exposition, with the current building opening in 1921. Today, the museum boasts over 40 million artifacts and specimens, and is one of the most popular natural history museums in the world, seeing over 1 million visitors a year. Right next door is the Shedd Aquarium. The aquarium got its start from John G. Shedd, president of department store giant Marshall Field & Company. Because every great city in the United States and Europe had a fine aquarium, he made it his goal to deliver Chicago the biggest and best aquarium. With a $2 million donation from Shedd, the aquarium broke ground in November of 1927 and would open to the public on May 30, 1930. Upon its opening, the Shedd Aquarium was the largest aquarium in the world. Today, the Shedd Aquarium has over 1,500 species of marine life in a 480,000 square foot building containing up to 5 million gallons of water. The Shedd Aquarium sees approximately 2 million visitors a year. Below is the Adler Planetarium. Originally founded and funded by Chicago business leader Max Adler, upon opening in May of 1930, it was the first planetarium in the Western Hemisphere. Today, the Adler is home to 3 full-size theaters, 12 space science exhibits that include the Gemini 12 space capsule, and a significant collection of scientific and space instruments. Another landmark on the lakefront is Soldier Field. Constructed in 1924, it is the home of the NFL Chicago Bears. Chicago is a very serious sports city. The city has a total of 8 professional sporting franchises. Chicago is one of 10 U.S. cities to have teams from the 5 major American professional team sports of baseball, football, basketball, hockey, and soccer. Each one of these franchises has won a championship in their respective league. Despite the unparalleled success of the Chicago Bulls in the 1990s, the city's favorite sports team of all time remains the 1985 Bears. In addition, Chicago is home to the women's franchises of the NWSL Chicago Red Stars and the WNBA Chicago Sky. In total, Chicago has won 21 championships, with their most recent title coming from the Chicago Sky in 2021.
If you enjoyed today's tour, you can tip your tour guide by hitting the like button. And while you're here, you might as well take another city tour, which you can do right here. Thank you for flying with Airworthy Tours, and we look forward to seeing you on our next flight.